just to go through your diagnosis, you've had a melanoma excise, and I'll just firstly explain what a melanoma is. This is a diagram of the skin, and a melanoma sits at the bottom of the first layer of the skin. It is a cancer of the pigment cells of the skin called melanocyte. Now, when this melanoma develops, it develops this way, going down into the second layer of the skin. As you sit within a group called a T2 melanoma. Now, if you put 100 people in the room outside, within that T2 group, between 1 and 2 millimetres, in 5 years' time, 89 of the 100 people would still be alive, and 11 of the 100 people would have died of their melanoma. Today here for is to go through your pathology. Now, unfortunately, there's a few worrying parts to the report, both in what was taken out from your leg and where the melanoma was, and also as far as the sentinel node is concerned. Okay? So I'll just highlight these with you. What that implies to me is that it means that the melanoma is already affecting your lymph system. Okay?
Yep.
And unfortunately, as happens in this situation of your sentinel node biopsies, the second lymph node that we took shows a small deposit of melanoma.
Right.
Okay. And that's quite a small deposit just sitting at the periphery of the lymph node, but it is still presence of melanoma in the lymph node. Now, the textbook treatment of your situation is to now carry out what's called a completion lymph node dissection, where the rest of the lymph nodes in that field in your groin where the sentinel node was taken from are removed.
Okay.
That's a bigger operation, it's a bigger scar, it means you'll be in hospital for a number of days after the procedure. And it obviously means that the risks of that procedure are greater than the original operation. Okay. Are you following me so far?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, to do that procedure, we need to do also what's called a staging set of investigations, looking for the possibility that the melanoma has spread inside. Because if there is spread of the melanoma inside, it means that any operation on your groin is probably, you know, of secondary concern. The CT scan you will have will be of your chest and abdomen. We'll be looking to see if there's any evidence of the melanoma having spread to your liver or your lungs, which is the two commonest sites it will spread to. And the other thing that we'll be looking for is any evidence of enlargement of the lymph nodes inside your pelvis. We then proceed to an operation on your groin here in Prince Alfred Hospital, probably within the next 2 to 4 weeks.
No worries. It's highly unlikely you think that it hasn't spread.
It's unlikely, Jay. I can't use any better word than that.
Say it has spread from my body. What chance of survival is that?
With melanoma, unfortunately, it's not very good. We don't really have good drugs to treat patients with who have spread of melanoma throughout their body. We know that ray treatment only works in certain specific situations in melanoma. This procedure is still to actually attempt to cure you of your melanoma. You asked me what percentage of patients will do well. It's approximately about 60% of patients will still be alive 5 years from now. So the reality is that the odds are still in your favour, although not as good as when we first spoke. Any final questions before we go in?
Just cure me.
Mrs. Shaley, this is Jay's daughter.
Hi, Shaley, how are you?
Good.
The operation itself, there was nothing at the operation that indicated anything abnormal was happening there.
Dr. Quinn said everything went well.
Good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Love you.
Me too. This is the worst feeling I've had in my whole life.
Yeah, I know.
You find out.
You've had your, after presenting with your melanoma, you had your melanoma excised, and then at the same time as re-excising that melanoma, we did a sentinel node biopsy, taking some indicated lymph nodes in your groin, unfortunately one of which was positive. You've then proceeded on to have the textbook treatment of that situation, which is to have the rest of the lymph nodes in your groin removed. Today we've got the pathology report back from that operation, and it's showing no further involvement.
Okay. Clear?
Clear. So your further pathology is good. Okay. And of course, it goes without saying that sort of further solarium use is out of the question.
No way. I don't want to go in the sun anymore.
Okay. Apart from that, it's see me again in 4 months' time.
Jeez. Any good words? No worries.
Okay.
2 months later, Jay and Janine tied the knot.
I promise to love, cherish, and honour you in sickness and in health.
It was a ceremony charged with emotion. Jay clearly overwhelmed by just how lucky he really is.
When I first met my wife, I used to use solariums. I was really scared. I just didn't know what to think. Just my whole world changed.
They're simple measures that Jay didn't take notice of. He wants to prevent others from experiencing the pain he's had to endure over the past year.
I'm clear now, but I've got a 65% chance of it coming back within 5 years.
Jay Allen has become the public face of anti-solarium campaigning in New South Wales. The 33-year-old says the mole on his ankle became cancerous after he used a solarium up to 20 times.
I'm in the shower feeling under my arms and in my groin for lumps, and there's not a day goes by I don't think about it. Just ban them, like there's no need for them. It can kill you.
Gabriella Rogers, Nine News.